Good morning, students. In today's class, we are going to see Power System Unit Commitment Problem, ADP, Adaptive Dynamic Programming for Optimal Network Reconfiguration in Distributed Automation. First, we will see the Power System Unit Commitment Problem. So, the main objective of the creating the objective function for the unit commitment problem can be formulated as a sum of cost of all units over the time and presented mathematically. So the mathematical representation of the formula for the constraint models of the optimal utilization problem is given as f is equal to summation t is equal to 1 to t, summation I is equal to 1 to n, ui of t, fi of t and plus si of t. So here ui of t is nothing but it is the ratio of your generation output. So what is the power output it has generated to that of your capability? It is the ratio of your generation to that of your capacity, ui of t. Then si of t is nothing but startup cost. Si of t is nothing but startup cost of ith unit at tth hour. And here fi of t is nothing but fuel cost for the ith unit. And here n is going to be the total number of units and t is going to be the total time under which your unit commitment is performed. Therefore, the objective of your unit commitment problem can be formulated as a sum of cost of all units over time. And it could be presented mathematically as a constraint model for the UC optimization problem, as over here. Next, when you are going to consider the unit commitment problem, there you are going to have the system energy balance. As a first step, you are going to have your system energy balance. Next, energy and power exchange. Then spinning reserve requirements and unit generation limit. As a first one, we are going to see what is meant by a system energy balance. Here, when you are going to see the system energy balance, here you are going to have the formula 0.5 summation I is equal to 1 to n ui of t, Pgi of t plus ui of t minus 1 Pgi of t minus 1, which is equal to Pd of t. Here, what is meant by Pd of t? Pd of t is nothing but power distributed. And here, when you are going to consider n is the total number of units in the system, and ui of t is going to be the ratio of your generation output and capacity. Pgi of t is nothing but power output of the ith unit at hour t. And u of I t plus 1 means at previous to ui of t, what is the value? That is ratio of your generation capacity and ratio of generation output and capability at time t is equal to t minus 1. Similarly, Pgi of t is nothing but power output at I minus 1th unit, which is nothing but the power distribution. It is the system energy balance. Next one, energy and power exchange. Energy and power exchange formula is Ei of t is equal to 0.5 into Pgi of t plus Pgi of t plus 1. Here Ei of t is nothing but your fuel cost, or we can say it is going to be the energy output of the ith unit at hour t, and Pgi of t is the power output, that is power generation output at ith unit. Here also power generation unit at the ith unit, and hour t here at hour t minus 1. It is your energy power exchange. Next is going to be the spinning reserve requirement. The spinning reserve requirement is given as summation I is equal to 1 to n ui of t, Pgi of t greater than or equal to Pd of t and Pr of t. So it is nothing but power distributed. It is power required at time t. Pgi of t is power output at ith unit in t hour. Ui is a ratio of your generation output and capability. Next, the last one is going to be the unit generation unit. Unit generation unit depends upon the power generation. which is given as PGI minimum, which should be less than or equal to PGI of T, PGI maximum. PGI of T is nothing but power output at ith unit at time T. In this, what is the minimum and maximum power required that we should identify? So in reverse constraints, the classification for reserve include the units of spinning reserves and the units on cold reserve under the condition of blank boiler. So Lagrangian relaxation is the most commonly used method for obtaining the solution for your unit commitment problem, and also it is considered to be as the most beneficial utilities with larger number of units. So as the number of units is going to increase, the solution by means of Lagrangian relaxation is going to be the most optimal method, because the degree of suboptimality is going goes to zero as the number of unit will goes on increasing. Therefore, it is easy to modify the model characteristics and specific utilities, and also it is very simple in case of your unit constraints. The major drawback of your Lagrangian relaxation method is inherent to suboptimality. So we can consider L of lambda mu v is equal to summation m is equal t is equal to 1 to t, I is equal to 1 to n. So inside this, it is going to focus on the multipliers associated with the requirement of time. So the multipliers associated with the requirement of the time is going to be lambda of t and mu of t. Lambda of t and mu of t is going to be the multipliers associated with the requirement for the with respect to time. Here PG is nothing but your power output, CI, it is going to be the constant, Lagrangian constant, and SI. SI is going to be the startup cost for the ith unit, and PD. PD is nothing but power distribution at time T is equal to 0. And this is going to be the representation for the minimum and maximum value for the power output at ith unit at hour T. Solution approaches that is using in case of your adaptive dynamic programming variant approaches. So the first solution, ADP, is going to be optimize the system over time under consideration for the noise and in uncertainty. Uncertainty, it is not only with respect to the nonlinearity occurring with respect to the system, it also depends upon the natural disaster. So if your optimal operation samples are used to train the network of your ADP, the neural network can learn to commit or adapt the generators, follow the operators patterns, and change the operation according to the load changing. And we have to look into the input network action that is stating towards your generators, and the action, how we are going to get the output, how we are going to adjust the output. So the output J will represents the cost to go function, and the task is to minimize your J function. So this is going to be the figure, whatever I'm going to show, it is going to be the schematic representation for the implementation of your heuristic dynamic programming. So in this diagram, you have the input as a state variable. So here you have the input. Is the input is going to be the state variable, that is x of t, which is nothing but the cost of generation of the vector. X is equal to cost generation function. Here you have four networks. One is action network, critic network, and the input is going to be your state variable. The input variable is going to be represented as x, which is equal to c of PGI. PGI is nothing but power generation at ith unit. The output is going to be the control. So output is going to be the control unit. The input unit is represented as U, which is equal to change in your power generation unit. And also you have the utility function as a local cost, so that the cost function about the unit generation with any time interval is given by U. U of t is equal to, it is the function of your power generation with respect to your time. After transposing the power unit, the power system variable as a guidelines, the scheme of the implementation of heuristic dynamic programming model include the computations such as, so here you can see over here, you have the input variable x of t. X of t plus 1 is the state variable at time t is equal to 1. Input variable u of t, and this is going to be the input variable at u of t plus 1. And j of t and j of t plus 1 is going to be the output. Now using this, we need to update the error of the critic network. The error of the critic network has two inputs. The first one is going to be your u of t plus 1. So when you are going to consider the error of your critic network, it is going to have two inputs. One is going to be your J of t, other one J of t plus 1, and other one it is going to be U of t. So when you are going to consider the critic network, it is going to have three things. First one, it is going to be your J of t. Second one, it is going to be J of t plus 1. Third one, it is going to be U of t. So along with J of t, you are going to connect one gain, which is gamma. So the output of this is going to be gamma into J of t. Therefore, the error of the critic network is written as, EC of t is equal to gamma J of t minus J t plus 1 minus U of t. Now we have to update the weight, because the weight factor, by continuously updating the weight factor, you can reduce the error. The weight factor is given as WC of t plus 1 is equal to WC of t, that is what is the weight required, plus the change in weight. With that, you can update the weight continuously until the weight error factor is reduced, so that we can get delta WC of t is equal to eta into EC minus dou EC of t divided by dou WC. So the solution for this, it is given as, after obtaining the solution, we will get gamma into EC. EC is nothing but your error of your critic network, and YCK, it is going to be your critic network constant. When you are going to see, it is here YC. YC is nothing but output layer of your output node, and WC. WC is nothing but weight between your input and hidden layer. If you are going to use WC of 1, if you are going to use like this, WC of 1 means WC is nothing but weight between the input layer and hidden layer. Suppose if we write it as WC2, then it is going to be the weight between the hidden layer and output layer. And whereas X is given as your input layer, YC is going to be your output layer, and K represents your number of nodes. So the error of your critical action of the computer network is calculated as follows. So with this, you are getting the equation as gamma ea wa jk to the power of 2. It is your weight network between your hidden layer and the output layer. Xi is going to be the input layer node, and h is nothing but your hidden layer between a to j, and y is going to be the output layer between a to k. So the error of action of the network is computed and the weight is updated as shown over here. Then the structure of the neural network. The structure of the neural network is shown over here. It comprises of three things. One is going to be your input layer, action network, critic network, and each of your action network is connected to each of the layer in your critic network. And here the weight updation factor is shown over here, each of your input layer. So action network comprises of three layer: input layer, hidden layer, and output layer. Each of your input layer is connected to your hidden layer, and each of the hidden layer is connected to the output layer. The weight factor is given as an input over here, and the weight recalculation is done at the hidden layer, and it is given to the output. So the system function is taken as the input for the input layer, and the system function will comprises of your control action. So the figure, whatever I have shown over here, we need to write the algorithm. So the load curve analysis for this 3 generator and 6 node system. So the figure, whatever it is shown over here, it is a load curve for the 3 generator and 6 node system. The closeness of the line graph that indicates the adaptive method generates the correct result. So with the implementation of your ADP method, adaptive dynamic programming method, it is possible for us to generate the correct result. After training, the HDP can give the generation plan which is very close to your optimal plan. The HDP method can deal with the dynamic process of unit commitment problem, and it can easily find a global optimal solution which is difficult for classical optimization method. So the next one is going to give the generation schedule for 3 generator system. So here we have x1 of t, x1 of t with the modification, x2 of t, x2 of t with the, after implementing the programming, here x3 of t After implementing the ADP method, what is your X3 of T? So it is shown for the three generator system. And in this figure, it shows a three generator system. X1, X2, X3 present the three generator. X1, it is the present and the expected. So previously, what is the output and what is the present output? ADP for optimal network reconfiguration in distribution automation. In this, we are going to see the distribution network are generally configured radially for the effective and non-complemented protection scheme. So under normal operating conditions, your distribution feeder may be reconfigured to satisfy the objectives of the line losses, minimal line losses, optimal voltage profile and overloading relief. The minimum distribution line loss is given as, it is subjected to the minimum value AII, which is equal to I, minimization or summation ZB and IB, where ZB is nothing but the impedance of the branch, I is going to be the M vector, this I is nothing but the M vector of the complex branch current, and A is going to be the matrix which depends upon the number of input state variables and your output variable. So network impedance matrix whose entities are going to be plus or minus 1. If this A matrix is going to be plus 1, if the branch B starts from node P. Suppose this A is will be equal to minus 1 if your branch B is going to start from node B. If it is not going to start either from branch B or branch N, branch P or B, then A will be equal to 0. And IB, ZB is going to be the impedance at branch. IB is nothing but branch impedance current. Now the system explains the fiber system, ADP method for fiber system. So it is solved by using the interior point method. And it involves the development of your ADP framework, which involves three networks. One is your action network, critic network and a plant model. So here we have shown four nodes, five nodes, five nodes. So it is for your example of your fiber system. The figure shows the ADP method for the fiber system. It involves the development of an ADP framework, which involves action network, critic network and the plant model. Algorithm to solve the problem using ADP method. So it has got the algorithm. The flowchart for the algorithm is shown over here. You can see here it has got the number of input hidden and the output nodes. As it is seen, we have three networks. One is action network, critic network and the plant layout. The action vector A will be calculated over here via the action neural network based R programming. Then J value is calculated for the critic neural network based on R, and a new action vector A will be created. Here it will check whether the J prior is equal to J. If it is so, it will go for the next step and the weight will be calculated, and the calculated weight will be converged for the criteria met. If so, it will summarize the output result. Otherwise, the weight factor will be recalculated again and again. So this is the concept of the algorithm to solve the problem of your ADP network. ADP structure network configuration. So here it is shown with three things. One is your action network, another one is your critic network, and next one is going to be your plant. So to solve this, we are going to use this particular network configuration is implemented for the algorithm. So it has got three functions. One is going to be your reward function. So under reward function, that is nothing but your utility function. The optimal reconfiguration involves the selecting the best set of branches to be open, one from each loop, such a way that the desired performance is obtained. And also we can see the performance criteria obtained from the optimal network reconfiguration. The one is going to be selected as the minimization of your real power loss. And also the application of your ADP to optimal reconfiguration of your radial distribution system has to be linked with the immediate reward. So this is the explanation for your ADP structure reconfiguration. With this, you can write the computed value of your immediate reward as U is equal to minus total losses. Next one, in this we have three networks. One is your action vector, critic vector and the plant. For the action vector, each of your control variable AI is going to be discretized in dual levels. For example, the branches to be open at each loop of your radial distribution system. So here it can be written as A is equal to pi, I is equal to 1 to m. That is your maximization function into DUI. Here m represents the total number of control variable. For example, if the total number of branches to be switched out, the control variables comprises of set of branches. So it has got certain rules and regulations that is framed according to the opening of the switches and closing of other switches. So based on this, we have framed a certain combinations for the radial structure network as A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, A6, A7, A8 and A9. So 10 combinations are framed for the adaptive dynamic programming structure network, the switching combinations for all the switches. Like if you see, take A1, it is going to be open switches 2 and 3, closed all the other switches. So only second and third switch will be open. Likewise, if you consider your 11th one, it is going, the switches 6 and 7 is going to be open and all other switches is going to be closed. If you consider A5, only 2 and 4 is open and all other switches are going to be closed. So it is written for the radial structure network. So why this combination ADP structure network is required in this sense? In order to write the algorithm. So as a first step, if you wanted to write the algorithm, we need to focus on the sample data that is pertaining to your action network. So when you take the sample data, the error is going to be the difference between your output and the real value. Once the sample data is taken, we have to train the data under the critic network with a pre-trained and unchanged action network. For example, if you are going to consider the input current state data x of t to the action network, getting the output u of t of the action network. So input is going to be u of t and the state variable is going to be x of t and the system function to get the state next time is going to be x of t plus 1. So using this x of t plus 1 for the next time, we can obtain the input function u of t plus 1. So the input, the action and the state. Now we have u of t. Now we have u of t, x of t, u of t plus 1, x of t plus 1. We have these two functions, that is u of t, x of t and u of t plus 1, x of t plus 1. Two different critic network and the J function for the same, that is J of t and J of t plus 1 can be obtained. Here the artificial neural network backpropagation algorithm is preferred in order to update the weight function of the critic and action network at time t is equal to t plus 1. And this particular structure network switching combinations can be incorporated while writing the algorithm to get the better result of your radial structured network. Thank you, students.